Hi, welcome to MooMooMath. Today we are going to learn about the Perpendicular Bisector Theorem. Okay, what is a perpendicular bisector? Let's break it down. First of all, what is perpendicular? Perpendicular means you have a right angle. Two lines that cross to form right angles. So we have a right angle. We also have a bisector, and a bisector means it cuts a segment into two equal parts right in the middle. So in this case, B is our midpoint. So if a point is on a perpendicular bisector of a segment, then it is equidistant, or that means the same distance from the endpoints of this segment. So we've got GF as our segment. We have AB, which is a perpendicular bisector. That means every single point that falls on this line is equidistant from F and G. So this point up here, A, is the same distance from F as it is from G because it falls on the perpendicular bisector. Well, it's kind of nice in geometry because then that makes two right triangles that are congruent to one another. So given L, the line, is the perpendicular bisector of FG, the segment, we can conclude that AF is equal to AG. Those distances are equal to each other. Now let's apply that perpendicular bisector theorem. So here's our first diagram. We have TS is our segment, and we've got RV, which is a perpendicular bisector. So TV, the segment's 14, so we know this one's 14. R would then be the same distance from S as it is from T, so RT is also 16, so that's our answer here. Okay, let's look at the second diagram. We're looking for the length of AB. Well, what do we know? Well, we know the segment AB is being bisected by this segment DC. So if it's being bisected, we know this side is 2.5, so the whole segment would be 5 because we'd add those together. And of course, we would know BC is 4 because this is 4 because we have two congruent triangles, but that's not what the question was asking, but that's something else you know. Now let's look at an algebraic problem. So JK is our segment, L is our midpoint, so JL and LK are both congruent. That means HJ, this segment, is congruent to HK, this segment. So if those two are congruent to each other, or equal, we can actually set those algebraic expressions equal to each other, and then we can solve. So let's subtract 3x, and that gives us 1 is equal to 2x minus 3, and then let's add 3. So 4 is equal to 2x, so that means x is equal to 2. So that's our answer, but we're not done, because let's go back and look. They're not asking us to find the value for x. They want us to find the length of HJ, the segment. So we're going to take the fact that x is 2 and plug it into our expression. 3 times 2, so we're replacing that x with 2, plus 1. 3 times 2 is 6, plus 1 is 7, so HJ is 7. Okay, now let's go down and write some equations. Okay, this next section says, write an equation in point-slope form for the perpendicular bisector of the segment with the given endpoints. Okay, so let's visualize what we have. We have a segment AB, so we have a point here, A, and a point B here. So there's a segment in between. We want to find the equation of the perpendicular bisector. So what's the equation of the line that cuts it in half and is perpendicular to it? Okay, so the first step is we have to find, well, where does this perpendicular bisector cross? So let's go in and find, the midpoint of AB. Okay, so to find the midpoint, we need to know our midpoint formula. Our midpoint formula is x1 plus x2 divided by 2, and y1 plus y2 divided by 2. You add your two coordinates together. So let's add our two x values together. 6 plus 0 divided by 2, that's 3. And then our second coordinate is negative 3, is our first y coordinate, plus 5 divided by 2. What's that ordered pair, that's going to be 2 over 2, which is 1. So there is our midpoint. Okay, that's the first thing we have to find. The second thing we have to find is we have to know what is the slope of AB, because the perpendicular bisector is going to be perpendicular to that. So the relationship between a line and its perpendicular is the negative reciprocal. So if we can find the slope of the AB, we can take its negative reciprocal. So let's take our ordered pairs. Here are ordered pairs, and let's do slope. So the slope equation is y2 minus y1 over x2 minus x1. So we subtract the y coordinates. So 5 minus a negative 3. We're still working with this ordered pair AB here. So 5 minus negative 3, and then 0 minus 6. And that leaves us with, say we end up adding that, that's going to be 8 over negative 6, which simplifies to negative 4/3. Okay, so that's the slope of AB. But we don't want the slope of AB. We want the slope of its perpendicular. So negative 4/3, the perpendicular slope is going to be positive, and that's flipping it, is taking the reciprocal, flip it over, and it's negative 4, positive 3/4. So now let's take this new slope that's perpendicular to AB, the point that we found, which is the midpoint, and put them together in the point slope formula. Well, the point slope formula is y2 minus y1, and I'm going to replace my y right there, is equal to m, which is my slope, x2 minus x1, which is my x I'm going to plug in. So I'm going to plug in the midpoint for x1, y1, and my slope for m. So this is x1, y1, and this is going to be my slope. So y minus 1 is equal to 3/4, parentheses, x minus 3. And there is the equation of the perpendicular bisector. And that's how you do it. So good luck with this. I hope this video was helpful on perpendicular bisector theorem.